Hello my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. Today we will be talking about working from home versus working from the office. So we will compare them, see which one is better and why we should go for work from home instead of working from the office. Right now I have years of experience working for different kind of companies throughout my whole life, and as a student I got my first job as a waitress, and it was in the United Kingdom, and I think that was the worst job I have ever had compared to all the other jobs I have had throughout my life. And I think that having different kind of jobs in offices, in retail, in, you know, different kind of workplaces, it gives you this kind of experience of what it means being treated differently by your co-workers and by your managers and your bosses in general. So when it comes to working from the office, I have learned that co-workers can either make up your day or ruin your day really badly, or if you are not under pressure, they will make you to be under pressure, especially my managers when I was working as a waitress. And I noticed that I have never liked my job when I was working in a specific physical place. And I would go for those jobs. I would try to sell myself as much as I could back in the day and get as many skills I could. Well, what kind of skill you would need as a waitress? I still had to sell myself for the company. And I think in my own personal opinion, the most ridiculous question is, why do you want to work for us? Why this company? What if I'm a student and I'm applying for a cleaning job? Or what if it's just a simple part-time job, right? For just a simple company. I would personally would never do this to any people that I would be interviewing personally, because I would be looking at if they know what they can do. Experience, yes, but you can be self-taught and you could be even better than a person who would have like education in it. And in general, I believe that right now working from home thing, having a job from working from home, is switching everything upside down. And I absolutely adore it and love it. And there are a few reasons why. For me personally is because I have never been happier for what I do. I have never felt more free than I am right now for what I do. I have never thought that I will have my own clients and I will manage my own time. I will be kind of my own boss in a way that I manage my own time, in the way that I work, and I am responsible for my own duties and no one is standing above me telling me what to do. I know what has to be done. And I do it at my own pace and time, as long as it's done. And I've never loved this thing as much as I do right now. And this being said, I think this is the best thing that could ever happen to humanity in general right now, especially if you can travel and work worldwide. So kudos to that, and let's get into the topic comparing actually pros and cons between working from home and working from the office. So let's begin with time difference. Did you ever think that you could work for a company that is located on the other continent and then to do a job for them? Well, I didn't. I always thought that I have to find a job that's located around me so that I could actually commute to job, to workplace, and to be there on time. spend some, you know, time doing this, and sometimes money if I would be starting early and there would be no buses going there, so I would have to take a taxi or take a 1 hour's walk. But the main thing is, between offices and working from home, is that when you work from home, you can do work for anybody. You can get employed by American company, by Australian company, by someone in Europe, by someone in Asia, as long as you know what you're doing and as long as you're good at what you're doing. So time difference is a huge thing when you are working from home. This is such a great benefit that allows people to be free to travel, to see the world, and to actually make an income while traveling, which back in the day it was hard or even impossible. Right now, that's an opportunity for all of us. And I absolutely love it, and I have never felt as happy as I am right now. So time difference, right? When you work in the office, you are stuck with that particular town, city, village, place where you are, right? Or you work from home and you are free to do traveling, to go and to live in Bali for the next year and just work for, let's say, American or Australian or European country. And that's perfectly fine. No one will judge you for it as long as you will do what you have to do. So the second thing is, you are in control of your own schedule. And that is awesome. There is no more 9-to-5 anymore, unless there are some remote companies that they still implement that 9-to-5, and when they send you your their own laptop to you. I've tried to work in that kind of company, and after a month, I just quit. I couldn't do it. There was too much pressure. They were tracking every single minute of my time, and they didn't even allow you to go to a bathroom and to get a coffee break. So that was all not paid. And well, just basically that company was not the best that I could work for. So I just quit. We've been trying to work for it over a month. I think it was 5 weeks or so. And when I say that you are in control of your own time, I mean it. And basically, when you work for, let's say, a company that's located in the US, you can do work at your own pace, as long as you do duties that you had to do, right? So while doing all those tasks that you had to do, you can complete them at your own pace. You schedule your own time. So when you work from home, you are responsible for planning your own time. If you have, let's say, weekly duties to do, right? But you just say, no, I'll do it in one day, and you actually manage to do it really, really well in one day, well, that's good for you, isn't it? Just do it. Obviously, I suggest to spread out your time evenly so that you would get actual focus and productivity every single day. But that's the main difference when you're working from home versus working from the office. When I was working in the office, all tasks were done, right? I would do them early, I would do them check. I would check them if they are done properly, if everything is all right, and then I would have to wait for those 10 last minutes, look at my watch again, sit doing nothing, and they would know that I'm doing nothing because I did everything that has to be done for that day completely, and I couldn't start doing anything else for tomorrow because the tasks would be assigned the next day. And I would be waiting, and they would be like, nope, you cannot leave until it's equally 6 p.m. because you will not get paid then for those 10 minutes. And it would trap me so much. I wouldn't understand this kind of policy, right? I had jobs where someone would be like, yeah, let's just go home. That's fine. You did what you did. That's fine. When I worked in one of the offices, although the next job would be like, nope, you gotta leave at the equally at that time. If you leave 1 minute early, you will not get paid. So that was awful, that was trapping me mentally, and it was a waste of time when you finish all your duties throughout the day, but they want you to sit there doing nothing. And then phone wouldn't be allowed, even if everything is done, anything wouldn't be allowed. You would just sit there looking at the wall or just like daydream, doing absolutely nothing. So I think that working from offices like this is just a waste of time. I'm not saying that every single office is like this, and I'm sure that there are good workspaces, but I'm talking from my own personal experience, what happened. And I have been in jobs where they would be threatening me that if I go 1 minute early, I will not get paid, even sometimes for the whole hour, when it was hourly pay, right? So as a student, well, you did 59 minutes of work and you're like, well, come on, it's only 1 minute left, right? So it's just, I think that's kind of an aggressive approach, obviously, to control your workers and to control this whole workspace. But I think this is going down. And when you work from home, if you do the task, you are free to go and do whatever you like. You didn't have to waste time anymore waiting and someone breathing on your neck that you cannot leave, when actually everything has been done, and spend those 10 minutes or whatever much time you have left to do something productive, like read a book, learn a skill, watch some Skillshare, or anything else whatsoever that could benefit you. Another amazing thing when you are working from home versus working from the office is you are in charge. And what I mean by that is you are not like your own boss, not in every single work from home position, although when you get tasks to be done, you become responsible. You get that responsibility trait. You have to plan your own time, your own tasks that you gotta do throughout the day to complete them. So there is nobody telling you and pointing you by finger what has to be done, when it has to be done, and how much time you have left to do it. If one task is taking faster for you as individual, you do it faster. If it's slower task, you do it at your own time, as long as you do it, but you do it properly. No one is actually telling you, you gotta do this in 2 minutes, and you end up doing like nothing, or you just end up doing some crappy work that doesn't work whatsoever, right? And then you get told off, it's not a good job, and blah, blah, blah. So you are your own boss, and you are learning that responsibility that helps you in the future. You are responsible for those duties yourself. So I think working from home is a huge benefit when it comes to responsibility, because that's on you. That's completely on you. If you will not be responsible enough, you'll get fired, or you will just lose that position. So again, that's on you. Another thing, when you work from home versus work in the office, you can be yourself. And what I mean by that is, if you're an extrovert, working in an office might be good for you, but then it depends how well you can focus on the duties that you're doing. Although for me, I am an introvert, and I would come back home drained after work, speaking with so many people, and I would not be able to focus on doing a proper job like as well as I could, just because I would want my like I would need a breather, if that makes sense. And I would go somewhere else and I would try to relax, because it would be too much a socialization for me in general. Whenever someone asks me how I feel, I always explain them, I know this is a weird explanation, but that I have this socialization like battery. And since I'm an introvert, if I speak a lot or if I interact too much, my battery gets drained, and I need some time to go away and to recharge myself, to recharge that battery. And whenever I would be working in the office, and if it would be a lot of people, a lot of drama, a lot of gossip, a lot of things happening, right, I would come back home, I would be so tired. I can't even explain this to you guys. I know that most of you have jobs or you are maybe freelancers. That's amazing. And whenever you go to that work, it's tiring. It's tiring. It's not that you only do physical job, you do an actual, you know, interactive job as well, interacting with customers, interacting with your co-workers, with your managers. One of my managers, when I was working in a fast food chain after I was a waitress, I had a lot of jobs when I was a student, and he would not be in a good mood because my manager would be going through, not like divorce, but something was going on in his family. I do understand that these things happen, although I do not appreciate when someone is putting this out on you. You have nothing to do with this, and I always think that if you need to talk this out, you have to go to a specific place and talk this out with someone who cares or who is there to listen to you. Although, if these are your workers, you cannot put this negativity on them when they have nothing to do with it. He would come and scream at us, few workers all together, out of nowhere, that we wouldn't do work as well in 1 minute faster than the other group or something like that. And he would just be so nitpicky. And I would speak with my other supervisors and I would be like, what happened, right? And they would be like, ah, he's going through some family stuff. But that's not a point where you can actually relieve yourself at someone else to put your negativity, to put your aggression towards someone else, because you will simply ruin their day. So when you work from home versus when you work from the office, in the office you can experience that. And I had a lot of experiences when someone would be in a bad mood and I would have to absorb their energy that would result in me getting drained, coming back home and sometimes even cry because I would be so affected by that negativity. Or just when you work from home, you don't have to deal with this. When you go on a call, you talk about what's actually needed about work. There is no some kind of discussion not related to work whatsoever. So working from home again is an amazing thing that could have happened because we are avoiding these things that could happen. If you like to make friends with your co-workers, kudos to you, that's amazing and that's what advised. But when you work from home, you might have a nice chat or just jump on a call with them, that's fine, but you will not be with them for 8 hours straight. That might result in mood swings, some, you know, complaining or something that's not even related to work that will drain you while speaking to them. So again, working from home is much better when it comes to this. Another thing is that all your work is based on actual progress. So when you work from home and not in the office, what they look at is not how you look, not how you speak with others, not how you do some unrelated stuff. Let's say, how do you act in general, how you walk and stuff, because some people would be looking at those things, like nitpicking with you. If they don't like your face, they will not get you promoted. So when you work from home, you work on actual progress. What they care about is your own progress on actual work that you do. It's not how you look, it's not how you live, it's not how you act. As long as the work is done, it's done correctly, accurately, and perfectly. So another thing why working from home is so much better than working from the office is that people for once are looking at your actual work rather than how you look or how you act. When I was working in the office, they would see that I do amazing job, they would give me compliments, but then it's my office policy, I can't give anything to you, you've been here only a few months, right? Or I can't promote you just because another girl worked here 5 years here, but she will not get promoted either because of our office policy, even though she would be amazing. So it's just that kind of grew on me when I started looking for work from home. but I could be working at my own pace, no one would be above me anymore, that no one would be controlling me and my time, and that I wouldn't have to deal with too many people and too much drama at the same time. So I really hope that you enjoyed this video, you guys, comparing work from home versus work from the office. There are still more benefits back and forth from work from home and work from the office. Whereas these two environments are extremely different, although I see personally many more benefits from working from home rather than working from the office based on my own personal experience. So if you like this video, give cheeky thumbs up. I wish you all to have an amazing day, you guys, and thank you for watching this video. Bye.